Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. Today I'm coming to share with you, hopefully quickly, how you can create this corset spine book cover. And I choose the size of this cover 8¾ by 5. It's very easy to make it if you've got the right tool, and it's not taking too long time. So I'm gonna explain you why this size, because I've been googling a little bit what kind of papers we are using here in UK, in Europe, and also in America, Canada, Philippines, and hopefully in the rest of the world, are not two different sizes of papers. That basic printer paper. This is A4 size. This paper measure, I think it's 11¾, it's long, and 8⅜, it's wide. In America, they've got 11 by 8½, so it's a little bit wider but a little bit shorter. So I was thinking, when I will halve this paper, the size of this, both, even here in Europe or in America, in Canada, it will fit to this cover here. It will be a little bit longer, both of them will be a little bit longer than is that cover, which gives me chance to decorate that edge with border punches, to make tabs on that edge of that paper. Or if I will don't have anything on that edge, I just can cut strip of paper from that end. It's more easy than to resize this size of cover. Because one of basic tools or basic things you will need for to make this cover, it's 12 by 12 sheet of paper, which you will cut just on 12 inches by 8¾ here, which means you will cut just one strip of paper, that's it, and you've got base for your cover done. You will just build up on this one. It's much more easy way to do it this way than to build up some different way, some difficult way, that base, and then continue with this corset strap or corset knitting. I still don't know how to call it, but that corset spine. So, as I said, one of materials you will need to make this cover, it's some decorative paper or, you know, that scrapbooking paper. You can use any you want. You can use some paper you don't like, because you can cover it, fully cover it with those layers. 12 by 8¾. Then you need 2 chipboard pieces, or you can use cereal boxes to make those pieces, or pizza boxes. It's totally up to you. I used chipboard, and you need 2 pieces, 4¾ inches by 8½, and you will need 1 piece 1 inch by 8½. The spine of that cover, it's 2 inches. To make that beautiful corset look, you have to make this top spine a little bit a little bit shorter. Skinny. I forgot to have a look again on that right word, but not wide 2 inches, but smaller. Yeah, that's the right word, because we want to see that corset crossing, you know. That's why the spine is only 1 inch. Then you need some paper for covering that chipboard or cereal boxes. I'm gonna use book pages for covering those chipboard pieces. If you will use cereal boxes or pizza boxes, that paper, it's mostly not too strong like chipboard. So it's good if you will choose, again, a decorative paper, because it will make it stronger. But it's totally up to you. And then you're gonna need to make that beautiful look of that corset, you're gonna need some fabric or lace, or this is a window blinder, something what will make that fabric layer between those two pieces between chipboard and the decorative paper. So this time I use this, I think it's called cotton fabric, because I'm gonna make this in a little bit vintage industry style. I'm gonna end up this, hopefully, in vintage industry style. That's why I choose this cotton fabric. What else you gonna need? Of course, you're gonna need the right tool for that. So, scoring board. Some tool which will make the holes through to your chipboards. I'm gonna use this crocodile. If you don't have crocodile, maybe you've got this Fiskars tool which makes holes for eyelets. You're gonna need eyelets. I'm gonna use those brass eyelets. They are 9 millimeters big. If you don't have something like this, maybe you've got some those pliers. These are terrible, but maybe you've got something like this. It can work as well, but these are very old and they are not straight anymore. So you can use some pliers like this, and glues for fabric and for paper. And what you have to do, once you've got cut your pieces on the top, we're gonna prepare that base part. Take your scoring board, take your paper 12 by 8 3/4. Choose which paper. If you wanna leave some, I've got double-sided paper, so now I have to choose which one I want to have inside of my journal. I wanna have that this one. So I'm gonna flip it down. And now we're gonna score. Pardon me. We're gonna score that base. We're gonna start on 5 inches. And then every 1/4 inch until 8 inches. It's that, oh no, 8 inches. 7 inches, until 7 inches, sorry. My wrong counting. Every 1/4 inch score, I have to move it here because this 5.5 score line, it's quite terrible. So it will be 8 lines. 1, 2, 3, I think. 4, 5, 6, 7. It will be a little bit more. 5 inches, every 1/4 inch, you're gonna make scoring line until 7 inches. It makes 9 scoring lines, okay? Every 1/4 inch. And I'm gonna explain you why. If you will wanna then, it probably can't be seen here. I choose wrong paper. If you will wanna then sew your papers inside, if you will don't use it just like cover, if you wanna sew your papers inside, this scoring will give you beautiful help with sewing your papers on the right position. It makes for it's prepared for 4 inserts this way. I choose very bad paper. Here you can't see those scoring lines, but I fold it every second scoring line. I fold it, and that middle lane will give me help where I should sew my papers inside. So once you have those score lines from 5 inches to 7 inches, you need to cover this piece with fabric. Use the glue, you know, it will hold properly. I'm gonna use this Uhu glue, and I'm gonna glue this piece of fabric on the top of my paper. Cover that base with fabric like this. And right now it's time when you will sew your signatures inside. It's prepared for 4 signatures or maybe more. It depends how big signatures you've got, but you've got score lines already prepared, so you will know where to where to go to show your signatures. Then you have to cover your chipboard pieces or, you know, those cardboard pieces to some decorative paper you want to have on your cover. I'm going to use those book pages and I'm going to cover all these pieces. So cover your pieces like this. If you want to use some distress ink on all these edges, use it now. And then what you need to do, flip your pieces. Flip it over, flip them over. You will need a ruler, the pencil, and now what you have to do with 1-inch spine, if you will make a bigger spine, I think it will be still same. 1/4 inch from these sides, make a mark. 1/4 inch from one side, 1/4 inch from other side. 1/4 inch, 1/4 inch, and put them together, those lines. I've got very short, very short ruler. Need bigger one. Just bear with me. I'm gonna take this bigger one. Make two lines on your spine, and one line on every pieces. I'm gonna show you how to choose to two line on the spine, 1/4 inch from the edges, from long edges, and this will be my spine. This will be my front cover. This will be my back cover. So remember, on front cover it will be this side where you will make 1/4 inch line here. I'm gonna draw it now just with my hand, but it will be spine here, a line here, and on back cover it will be from this side, 1/4 inch line here. Okay, I'm gonna take my ruler and I'm gonna make those lines properly later on. And then what you will have to do, I think the best way, and make sure that you will have those points on a proper way, take a ruler again and make every 1 inch, make dot here. Oh, I will have to, I'm sorry, I have to flip it like this to see on that. Every, too many things and too long ruler now. Oh yeah, okay. Come on, move. Okay, every 1 inch make point. Here, I can't see four, but it's somewhere here. Here. Every 1 inch, same on that other piece. Oops, 1 inch. Inch made, make small dots or small lines, and then take that ruler, keep those three pieces together as they go, and you will see you've got line here, here, here on that spine, and here it's my mark for 1 inch and 1 inch here. I'm gonna place my ruler there. And I'm just gonna put those lines together. Here it's second inch, here is second inch again. With that ruler, I'm gonna make marks on all three those pieces. Like this. Wait, not this way. Good. It's moving. Put together every these marks you made, and here, and it made points here. Here is one dot where those lines are crossing. These will be points where you will make a holes using your tool, which means then you will put the tool, oops, have to move it here, and you will put the tool where those two lines are crossing together. You will put it right in the middle where its hole maker is going. And you will make holes on every those crossing lines, which means here will be holes just here. On that spine will be holes here and here. Every crossing lines, you will make a hole. Like this. So we have all holes. Now what you have to do is put to all your holes those eyelets and fix them inside. So put the eyelets, fix the eyelets like this. And now it's time when we will start to tie up laces or trims or even chains. I already tried that, if I will find it somewhere here. I already tried to do spine with a chain, with mix of chain and the thread, and I know I will use it first in palm. And I have to say that I like it. It gives a little bit more interest to that spine. So choose your material for this crossing, and we're gonna start. You will need a piece, not piece, some material which is long. When you fold, when you fold it on the half, it have to be one and probably half, one and half leg of your cover. And we're gonna start on the front cover from the top. Put together front cover with a spine, hold this and try to put it to the half, and then I'm gonna move this from this eye. We're gonna go down and up across here. From this eyelet, we're gonna go down here and up like this. And again, from this side down, come on, and up. From this side down and up. Continue like this until the end, like this. And this is when I had one and a half, when you fold it on the half. So I had one and half of leg of my cover, so you will end up with something like this. If you need a little bit longer edges, if you are not sure how you will work with this trim or lace, make it longer. It's totally up to you. If you don't mind that, you will here have a little bit longer edges, then you can cut it out. It's probably sometimes much more better to have longer piece and make sure that you will get to that end. And now we're gonna start to that other half, from the spine to the back cover. Grab it on the half. Come on. Like this. I hope I'm in half. Yes, like this. And again, it will be from the top eyelet to across bottom. From the top across to the bottom. From the top across to the bottom one. It's same like on that right side. So till the end, like this. And now it's time when we will come back to our base. If you decide to sew your pages inside to this journal, you already have sewn them inside, because they have to be sewn before we will put this on that base. So if you want to sew your pages inside, do it now before you will start to put this corset cross cover on the top. So I decide I'm gonna use it just like a cover for book, not like a journal. So I'm gonna start right now. Don't tie these straps yet here down there, because we need to have this flexible to place it on the sides of our journal. Here you can use a glue you like, maybe that fiber tack, or I don't know, some strong glue, tacky glue, any glue you believe, or you can use hot glue gun. I'm gonna use it here. Put the hot glue on the front cover, not like this. Oopsla. I'm sorry. It's falling down. Everything is falling down. Okay. And place this piece on your prepared book cover. Like this. You can see that edge underneath. Same it will be with that back cover. Bit more glue. Put the glue on that back cover. Do not do anything yet to that middle part, not spine yet. Oh, not like this. Make sure you've got it on the right place. So if you are not sure with hot glue, maybe for you will be better some different glue. Like I am not here. Aha, see? Like I'm not here, I have to unglue it. Okay, I did unglue it because it wasn't on the right space for that back cover. I'm gonna use this UHU glue. It gives me a little bit more time to place it on the right space. So if you are not sure, if you are not quick enough for that hot glue, use different glue. Some glue which gives you time to place it on the right space, place on the right position, like here, and then you will have to wait until it will dry. I'm gonna wait until it will dry. Now you have a time to position that spine in the middle. You can put a little bit of glue on the top and on the bottom to fit it there. Just a little bit, don't put too much of glue in there, because the flexibility of this one, it's good for those corset wraps. And now it's time to make these even, nice, and it's time to start decorate your cover like this, and you've got your corset cover done. So this is my sharing for today. I hope it wasn't too difficult. The most hard or longer time it's taking to put all these eyelets to those holes, to make those holes and put all these eyelets to those holes. That's probably the longest part of making this cover, but that cover itself, it's not too hard to make. It's loads of work, especially with them, but it's not too hard. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Hopefully in next one it will be how to decorate it, hopefully. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful week and see you next time. Bye.